So my topic of presentation is character analysis of most wanted criminals across the world on the basis of their early life. So we often tend to jump to conclusion of who did what, whether it's about stealing an eraser from or killing someone. The conclusion behind this paper is not to justify their act at all, but to analyze what made them so inhuman and evil. What actually influenced them to be a killer? Many theories in psychology strive to prove that our childhood, our past traumas plays a major role in affecting behavioral and social life in future. But is it enough to push someone to be a brutal murderer? This study comprises of character analysis of five different worst serial killer of all times, and how they have been influenced by a very bad childhood and cruel early life traumas to be a killer. Nelson Mandela believed that when someone is denied the right to live,
you should please continue. Ask
ma'am, the... Can I continue?
Yeah, please continue.
Okay, ma'am. Nelson Mandela believed that when someone is denied the right to live the life he believes in, he has no choice but to become an outlaw. People believe different aspect of criminal. Some think they are born with sick mindset, while the others think that no one is born a criminal, but somehow becomes when society, bad parenting, mishappening, or wrong influences are projected on them. So my study is about five different people with sick mind, but it is combined with their brutal childhood and how they became the most feared psychopath. So first is Pedro Lopez. He was a Colombian serial killer who was convicted for 110 murder, but he has claimed to rape and murder of over 350 women. According to his mother, when he was a child, he was a very polite boy and he wanted to be a teacher. However, he was raised witnessing prostitution, and he was abandoned from his home. Later, he was abducted by a man and he was raped over and over again. And he was molested by a male teacher as well. Lopez claimed that while he was in jail for a car theft, he was brutally gang raped. And then, however, later he found them and killed them. The worst case is that he has told that Indians in Peru has tied him up, buried him into sand up to his neck, and they put syrup on him so that he'll be eaten by ants. However, an American lady saved him. So this was the childhood of Pedro Lopez, who was one of the most famous serial killer. Next is Ellen Warnos, who killed 7 men in Florida and was executed by lethal injection. Her father was later convicted in sex-related crime, and he was suffering from schizophrenia. Her grandfather was abusive and assaulted her, and even as the consequences of that, she became pregnant. She ran away from home and started working as a sex worker only at the minor age of 15. Her first kill was a rapist who brutally beaten her and assaulted her. She was suffering from borderline personality disorder and antisocial personality disorder. One of the famous quote that she said is that she loves killing, and she would, one of the famous quotes she said that, "I robbed them and I killed them as cold as ice, and I would do it again because I know I kill another person because I have hated humans for a long time." So this was the brutal childhood and past trauma that was involved in the serial killer. Next is Andre Chicato, who claimed to have 56 murder. His entire childhood was went in starvation and war. And he was so starving, he claimed that he and his family were dependent on eating grass to survive that. He was bullied because of his importance. He was bullied by his fellow mate and by his girlfriend and their friends. He was, so he, the feeling of stabbing and killing other women. And one of the things is that his mother was brutally harming him, beating him because he was having chronic bedwetting disorder. Next serial killer is Charles Edmund Cullen. His mother died when he was in high school. He was without father and his mother died and the hospital didn't allow the body to go home. They dehumanized the body. He killed 40 patients while he was working as a nurse. He said he has a miserable childhood. He was bullied by his sister's boyfriends and his schoolmates. He attempted suicide almost 3 to 5 times in his early life as well as while he was in Navy. His motive was to kill in order to spare them from sufferings and not being coded and prevent hospital from dehumanizing them just like they did in the case of their mother. So he was thinking he was doing a good job by relieving them from pain. The last serial killer was a werewolf killer, also known as Mikhail Popkov. He has claimed to, he was convicted for 78 crimes, 78 murders, and was convicted for more than confessed more than 83 plus kill. He was married and he was leading a happy life. However, he was a neglected child and witnessed his parents doing adultery. Later on, he found that his wife is also cheating on him, and that was a major impact on his mental life. His killing motive was very simple. He called the female, their partner, as immoral. He gave them two options, whether you want a party or do you want to go home. He also dropped the woman who wants to go home. However, if woman is abandoning their home to party or to stay with him, he raped her and then he killed her fearlessly. So this was the character analysis of 5 serial killers that has been coming from a very brutal and very pathetic childhood and traumas. Certain theories also tell us that our childhood shapes our future, how we are going to be as a person, like social theory of child development, behavioral child development, Eric Erisel psychological child development theory, who also states that any changes, any trauma can shape the person, and that is not happening as a child but also in their whole lifespan. Freud psychosexual theory highlights the importance of experience in childhood and how they have serious mental issues if they fail to attain satisfaction in their psychosexual ages. The cognitive theory of child development focuses on how a child thought process change over the course of childhood. So this is my final conclusion that I have drawn here. A woman is thinking killing is fun. She belongs to a sick mindset. She is thinking killing is fun, so let's give it a try, let's kill. And the boy is coming from a very bad childhood, very bad shape. He is thinking people have wronged me. Humans are the worst, so I will kill them. And somehow when the killing arises, I think these two things, a sick mindset and a something wrong, combined. And that's how these are the stories of a serial killer. I'm done with my presentation. Thank you.